Good morning, everyone. With this presentation, we are going to highlight certain aspects related to speech and language and communication development in children. Language development in children is known to be an emergence behavior. With emergence, we consider that the language emerges in a child. Like, there are certain milestones which come in a child's development. Where initially a child, there are certain early interactions which happens in the early environment of a child, right? When the child is around 2-3 months old. Soon, like as the child progresses towards the age of like 7-8 months, the certain comprehension sets into place. And this comprehension then leads to the attainment of first word at around 1 year of age, which is gradually carried over to phrases and sentences at the age of 3 years. And soon these particular language development takes the particular form of narratives and the conversational skills which mature at the age of 7 years. With emergence, we really mean that if the first word has established, the entire vocabulary comes into play in the child's development. And thereafter, when the child uses certain phrases, there is a spurt in the development of phrase level of a particular child. The three terms are communication, language and speech itself. With communication, we mean the entire exchange of information. Right, whatever it involves, language is a predominant function. Right, the language is the mode to communicate, but there are other things which includes the non-verbal language or the non-verbal aspects of language, including all the body gestures, the facial expressions, and the other factors, the eye contact, the eye gaze, the others. Thereafter, the language is a symbolic function. With symbolic, we mean that it has certain words, right, and these words are there to be used in a particular sequence which is ruled by a certain system, right? There are certain words. If you say, I have to go to market, right? Yeah, I have gone to market. The way you use these particular words, they hold a particular meaning and they are governed by certain rules. So this is what the language is about. Moving further, particularly language has two particular forms, the written form and the oral verbal form. There is a particular language, the sign language, which is well known to be used by the hearing impaired population. This particular language, it has no verbal form, right? It has all the gestures and all it is ruled by certain rules, but there are no speech to communicate through words. And speech, whereas is referred to the oral verbal form of the language. So what happens is, if communication is this circle, language is a part of it and speech is again a part of the communication in whole and language in particular. Moving further to the factors that foster this particular speech and language and communication abilities in a child. The first one, we can say that could be the environment. With environment, we mean the people who are there in the child's zone. A child attains a particular language which is being used in the child's particular setup. So, environment plays an important role in deciding what language the child is going to use in the initial years. Now, moving further towards the sense, how the motor sensory system is related to foster the child's speech and language development. When we talk of motor abilities, like, let us imagine a child who is like, how do they communicate before attaining language, right? They will lift their arms if they have to come to your lap. Like, they will be grabbing something if they have to take something. The pointing emerges, which is again a motor skill. And dragging towards a particular object, which includes the limb mobility to approach a particular object. So this all non-verbal communication is possible because the child is growing on the motor abilities, right? If the child, consider the child with cerebral palsy, if the motor movements are not happening at the pace the child should be doing, as a typically growing child does, the entire non-verbal communication is at hold, right? There is no, maybe depending upon the severity the CP child is performing. Now, how this is again related to the verbal communication, the oral verbal form of communication is these initial non-verbal communications, they provide a child with the communication intent, right? A child will have the intent to communicate, and thus the verbal The oral verbal form of communication or language comes into play when the child is around 1 year of age. So there is a correlation. If the non-verbal language is in place, the communication is in place, the verbal language is fostered, which is directly related to the child's motor development. So moving further, there are certain oromotor skills, like how these oromotor skills of a child are dependent on the attaining the motor skill, the developing motor skills of a child. Starting with, let's look at a child who is lying on bed or something, right? When a child has those lying period of like around 2 to 3 months of age, you will hear more of gurgle sounds and cooing in a child, right? Because the child is laying, the tongue of the child is in the back, right? So you will have only the gurgles and the cooing sounds. Like moving further, as the child starts to sit, right, they attain, as the sitting posture is emerging, the muscle which has its dominant function is the jaw muscle, right, because the child has to hold the jaw against the gravity, right. Soon at that very age, when the child has started to sit, you will hear more of babbling sounds in his child, right, because the jaw control is emerging in that particular child. Moving further, towards the other motor skills, it is the suck, swallow, breathing reflux, right? Suck, swallow, breathing coordination, which emerges around 9 months of age, right? When this particular coordination is maturing in a child, you will hear more consistent sounds. A parent is going to report to you that they hear the child saying mommy word or papa word, though they are not consistent, but the sound forms are consistent when the child is emerging. Soon after the 1 year of age, the tongue orientations become becomes much more considerate of the oral motor skills of the child, which leads to the oral play happening to a child. When the child is playing with the oral sounds, you will hear more number of sounds that the child produces. You may hear the sound, or you may hear the sound emerging. So it is entirely related to the oral motor skills maturation happening at that time. Now moving forward, when we talk of the lip movements, like we hear the bilabial sounds at the age of around 6-7 months, but the lip movements, they mature at the age of around 18 months to the age of 2 years. And when this coordination is happening between 18 months to 2 years, you find the child using more coordination of the articulators and more consistent words emerges in a particular child, and thus the intelligibility of speech follows in. So, with this coordination, we can correlate that because every development is so hierarchical in any child's development. When the gross body movements are happening fine, it leads to fine motor movements. When the fine motor movements are happening fine, the oral motor maturation happens to a particular child, which sets in for the speech development in any child. And also, I would like to mention that we have always seen that the child who has delayed motor development, the initial milestone of the child who walks late, they often talk late, right? This is happening because this entire sequence of motor development is happening at some deviated rate or a delayed rate. Now, moving forward, how the sensory system maturation helps in speech and language development. Basically, there are five senses which we all have known of. There are two more what a sensory profile of a child matures on. Those are vestibular and proprioceptive sensory system of a child. As with regards to the sensory system, I would like to highlight upon the play pattern of a child, right? When a child is around 2-3 months old, the toys that you give to a child are more of visual toys, right? In the swing, the child will have that thing that keeps moving, the moving toys, right? Because of visual senses actually growing up. Then, as soon as this visual sensory maturation is happening, it is taken up by the auditory maturation or the auditory sense maturation. So, when the child is around 5 to 6 months, we provide them with the rattles and these kind of toys, right, where they can actually explore their limb movements, and the auditory sense emerges with respect to that. Thereafter, when the child starts sitting and crawling and these things emerges, we provide them with the moving tones, right, which actually fosters both the things, and then they are replaced by cause and effect tones at the later stages. Moving further, so this means that the maturing of the sensory system and the maturing motor system system sets in the pre-linguistic skills of a child. With pre-linguistic skills, we mean the eye contact, the joint attention, the sustained attention, and the compliance of the child emerges, which helps them in attaining the language. And as this language is attained by a child, these social, emotional, and cognitive skills take the mature form of language as we grow. This all is entirely depends upon the child's sensory and the motor system maturation. So the journey to attain the first meaningful word requires the most of the effort on with a child when a child has any communication disorder, because to initiate that communication channel with a child, you need to have certain adequate amount of sensory and motor maturation. And then when these things are into play, the child responds, they start communicating with respect to their pre-linguistic skills, and thereafter the comprehension of language happens, which leads to the language as a core in development. And then the oral integrity comes into play, which refers to the entire speech modality to be used as a communication mode. And why the struggle is there to attain a child who has this particular first word delay is that you have to prepare many a times when the other things are happening along with the child. You need to focus more on the child's abilities, in particular with the oral imitation, right? It is very difficult to make a child copy your oral movements, which needs entire motor system maturation, entire sensory system maturation, and entire cognitive, social, and emotional skills of a child to a level that they're going to actually copy and learn speech as a function to communicate. Thank you.